Good morning, all of you. We are discussing about the significant figures. Yesterday I told already some rules for the how to find out the significant figures, and I will tell you here some other things. For example, if you have exact values means, for example, you have five apples we have means, how can you write it this one? 5 point. Is there any chance to get 5.1, 5.2 like that? No chance. That's why error in this will be coming like this. So many zeros will be coming. All should be considered as a significant figures. That's why exact values having infinite number of significant figures. Infinite significant figures. Okay, for example, I will tell you some other things in case of scientific notations. Scientific notations means all constant values in physics and chemistry all undercomes scientific notations. For example, you have Planck's constant value is there 6.625 × 10⁻²⁷. In case of scientific notation, we have to see only significant figures for capital N. Means how many significant figures we have? 4 significant figures will be having. So whatever exponential will be there is not required to us. Like that, for example, if we can take Avogadro number means 6.023 × 10⁻²³ also has 4 significant figures. These are the rules to find out the significant figures. Under significant figures, we have two concepts. One is addition and subtraction. Under addition and subtraction, how do you find out the significant figures for resultant answer? For example, you have 5.1, 2.12 and 3.235 is there. He given additional value or subtraction value will be remained, same rules will be there. First you add them, you are getting 5 and 5 and 4 and we are getting 10.455. But in answer, sir, 5 significant figures is there means is a wrong answer. So among the added value in which digits we have lesser number of digits after decimal. Only one digit we have here, 2 will be there, here 3 will be there. Answer has to be cut to get one digit after decimal point. Then we have to take this one and we have how many significant figures? 3 significant figures we have. I will tell you one more thing, like multiplication and as well as division. Under multiplication and division we have one more rule. See, for example, 2.5 × 6.023 × 10⁻²³ by 3.8 × 10⁴. So in competitive examination, no need to do that simplification clearly, observe very clearly. So if you take like this, this one has how many significant figures? 2 significant figures. This one has 4 significant figures. This one has 2 significant figures. So whatever answer is coming among all these significant figures, which is the least? So 2 significant figures having by answer. Whatever is coming answer in that, how many significant figures has to be modified to significant figures. Not like that, here one point is coming. For example, you have 5 × 2.38 × 5.6 is there by 1.423 is there. No need to do simplification. Is exact number. Exact number means infinite number of significant figures. It is having 2 significant figures, sorry, 3 significant figures. This is having 2 significant figures. This is having 4 significant figures. No need to do simplification. We can tell answer should has a least number of significant figures. That is nothing but 2 is the answer. So is the exact number, the spy has infinite number of significant figures. All of you understood? Yes. Now we are going to discuss is a further thing, is nothing but percentage composition. This is important for competitive examination. परसेंटेज कंपोजिशन ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट पार्टिकल इन मॉलिक्यूल और कॉम्पाउंड. ओके, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वन सर? फॉर एग्जाम्पल, ही गिवन टू यू वाटर. इन वाटर व्हाट इज द परसेंटेज ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन? हाउ डू यू कैलकुलेट? जस्ट आई विल टेल यू फॉर्मूला फॉर दिस वन. परसेंटेज ऑफ ए कॉन्स्टेंट पार्टिकल इज इक्वल्स टू वेट ऑफ दैट एलिमेंट वॉट एवर इट इज बाय मॉलिकुलर वेट ऑफ द कॉम्पाउंड इन टू 100. वेट ऑफ दैट एलिमेंट बाय मॉलिकुलर वेट ऑफ द कॉम्पाउंड इन टू 100. नाउ यू कैन चेक इट हियर. H परसेंटेज, H परसेंटेज इन वाटर, हाउ मेनी हाइड्रोजन्स? टू हाइड्रोजन ईच वन, वन टू वन सर टू बाय 18 इन टू 100. नो सर, आई वॉन्ट ऑक्सीजन परसेंटेज, हाउ मेनी आर देर? वन ऑक्सीजन. सो वेट ऑफ दैट एलिमेंट मीन्स वेट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन, वेट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन मीन्स वन ऑक्सीजन, वन ऑक्सीजन मीन्स 16 बाय मॉलिकुलर वेट इज 18 इन टू 100. Okay, if you can do here, some of the percentages is around 9 times here, nothing but we are getting 100 means 11.11% you are getting. Here I think you are getting 88.88% we are getting of oxygen. Did you observe or no? In this water molecule, what are the conditions? Some of these two percentages should be coming 100% is a very important point. Some of percentages of all constant particles is equals to 100. Yes, how many constant particle is there together? Percentage is nothing but 100 is coming. So nothing but hydrogen percentage plus oxygen percentage in water is equals to 100. Not like that. For example, he given carbon percentage is 70% and hydrogen percentage given as 20% given. So now together percentage is nothing but how much? 90% is there. Is it giving 100? No. How much lagging is there? 10% lagging is there. Whatever lagging percentage is there for 100%, that is related to oxygen. Yes, this is important point. So in some problems, he will give few element percentage, he will give is not coming 100, then lagging 400, how much is there? That is always related to oxygen percentage. Are you understanding or no? This is a very important point we are discussing. Later, we are going for some other important things is nothing but a molecular formula and empirical formula. Before going to molecular and empirical formula, we have to do something. If for example, he given carbon percentage given, hydrogen percentage given, oxygen percentage given. Carbon percentage how much given? 70 and 20 and 10. How you will get the empirical formula? What is that one? I will tell you. So what is the percentage by its atomic weight? 12 and by atomic weight 1, by atomic weight oxygen. Among all these, I think you will get very less is nothing but this one, 0.6 we are getting. So among all the ratios, what is the least number? With that number we have to divide all these, then we are getting simplest ratio we are getting. That simplest ratio means is nothing but 1, 2, 3 you got for example. Then what is the empirical formula? Is nothing but C1 and H2 and O3. No, you got a simplest ratio maybe 1.5 and 2.5 and 3 you got. So always simplest ratio should be whole numbers. Then what we should do, we have to multiply with one common number to get the whole numbers. Then it is nothing but 3 and it is nothing but 5, it is nothing but 6. Then what is the formula? C3, H5 and O6. No, you got simplest ratio is 1.33 and 2 and 2. We can leave it like this, don't make it as a round up. So we should multiply this number with one suitable number should get whole number. Then for example, I want to multiply it with one common number 3, into 3 and into 3. Then what you are getting? 3.99 means we can write it as 4 and 6 and 6, then C4 and H6 and O6. These are the empirical formula, these rules are very important. Now what is the meaning of molecular formula and empirical formula? Molecular formula of a substance is gives as exact exact number of atoms in a molecule. Atoms in a molecule. For example, water is there. Molecular formula tell 2 hydrogen atoms and 1 oxygen atom is there. Like that, carbon dioxide is there. It gives molecular formula means 1 carbon atom is there and 2 oxygen atoms were there. So it gives the exact information or exact number of atoms in the molecule given by the molecular formula. What is the meaning of empirical formula? Anybody? Empirical formula means is nothing but simplest ratio. Simplest ratio of constant particle in molecule is called empirical formula. Sir, what is the meaning of simplest ratio? For example, take benzene. Benzene molecular formula is what? C6H6. And empirical formula means carbon is to hydrogen ratio. 6 carbons and 6 hydrogen. Common factor deleted. We are getting 1 and 1. C1 and H1 is nothing but CH is the empirical formula. I will tell you some other example. For example, if you take acetylene molecular formula is C2H2, but I want empirical formula, carbon and hydrogen atom ratio. How many carbons? 2 carbons. How many hydrogens? 2. Common factor 1, C1H1 is nothing but CH is the empirical formula. For example, you have ammonia. You have ammonia molecular formula is NH3. Empirical formula, N is to H. Is there any common factor? 1 and 3. No common factor. So empirical formula is equals to molecular formula. So it is only empirical formula is nothing but molecular formula is nothing but NH3. We have to stress this point. In any molecule, if there is no common factor, then molecular formula is becoming empirical formula. And later we have to discuss some other important things. Relation between molecular formula and empirical formula. For example, you take an benzene. Benzene is there. From here you are getting some information. Benzene molecular formula is C6H6 and empirical formula is CH. How you will equalize them? Yes, you are getting molecular formula is equals to 6 into CH. So molecular formula means C6H6 is equals to 6 into CH means empirical formula. So commonly we can write molecular formula is equals to some whole number into empirical formula. This is important. Molecular formula is equals to some whole number N into empirical formula. Now, I want to get some important information here is nothing but N value. N value means molecular formula by empirical formula. We have to take molecular formula weight by empirical formula weight has to be taken. So how do you cut molecular formula or molecular weight, sir? You know very well, if you take just you can complete here concept. N value is equals to molecular formula weight by empirical formula weight. Okay, in some of the problems he may give vapor density. Vapor density means what? Density of the substance by density of the hydrogen gas. Vapor density. So density of the substance by density of the hydrogen gas. Okay, if you can simplify this one, whatever it is not a matter to us. We are getting molecular weight is equals to 2 into vapor density. Yes, this is the very important concept. Generally, vapor density means density of a particular substance by density of the hydrogen gas. After doing calculation by using ideal gas equation, we are getting molecular weight is equals to double the vapor density. So in some of the problems, vapor density will give, we can get it, molecular weight is equals to 2 into vapor density. All of you understanding? Now I will tell you some chemicals. For example, molecular weight of glucose C6H12O6. How do you get the molecular weight? Some of its atomic weights. 6 carbons is there, plus 12 hydrogens is there, plus 6 oxygens will be there. Together is calling as a molecular weight. Okay, each carbon 12, 6 12s are 72, plus each hydrogen atomic weight 1, 12 ones are 12, each oxygen 16, 6 16s are 96. Together we are getting, I think, 180.
Are you understanding? Yes, like that if you can get it a molecular weight is important concept. Molecular weight of CO2 I want. Some of its atomic weight. One carbon is there and two oxygens will be there. One carbon means 12. Two oxygens, two 16s are 32. We are getting how much? 44 we are getting. The very important concept today is we discussed about the percentage composition of the element. From there we got empirical formula, molecular formula, relation, and how to find out the molecular masses. All of you understood or no? Yes. See carefully the concept is just once go through the things carefully, you can enjoy the things. See, if you learn point to point very carefully, whatever you are giving object to, it is nothing for you. But without basics, we can't do anything. So yesterday we learned laws of chemical combination. Today we learned empirical formula and molecular formula. And now we are going to discuss about the very important concept, is nothing but mole concept. See the things carefully, a mole concept you are discussing. Mole concept. All of you pay attention here. Already you know it, even though the things are very, very important. Mole concept. Mole concept means, first of all, we have to learn about AMU. What is the meaning of AMU? Atomic mass unit, also calling as unified mass, denoted by U. And it is actually 12th part of mass of one C12 atom, carbon 12 atom. Actually, what is this one? 1 by 12th part of, by using spectroscopic method, they calculated or they absorbed mass of single carbon atom is 1.99 into 10 to the power of minus 23 grams. Once imagine 2 into 10 to the power of minus 23 grams is very, very small. In that again, 12th part. 12th part means we are getting 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 24 grams we are getting. So then write on, 1 AMU is equals to 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 24 grams. Means where we are using this one, sir? If AMU we are using for very, very smaller weights, very, very smaller weights like a single atom or molecule. To express a single atom or a single molecule, we are expressing them in AMUs. Okay, what is the concept of this one? Just I will tell you. For example, I want atomic weight of hydrogen. Indirectly meaning is single hydrogen atom weight. Single hydrogen atom weight is nothing but 1 AMU. We can write it as 1 U also. And I want atomic weight of oxygen. Indirectly, 1 single oxygen atom weight, 16 AMU. Okay, not like that. I want just molecular weight of the water. What is the indirect meaning? 1 molecule water weight. 1 molecule water weight means too small. Too small means what is this one? Together mass is 18 and AMU. Like that, I want molecular weight of the CO2. Actually, meaning is what? 1 CO2 molecule weight. 1 CO2 molecule means together. Together means 44 should be expressed in AMU or unified mass. Now, we are going to discuss about the mole. Yes, this is the one of the unit to express the quantity of the chemical substances. So what is the meaning of mole? Means is nothing but you are taking some quantity of the substance. In that substance we have Avogadro number of the particles we have. So Avogadro number of the particle means 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 particles we have. Then weight of the substance is called as 1 mole of the substance. You have some quantity of the substance, in that we have Avogadro number of the particle, then the quantity of the substance is calling as a 1 mole substance. Nothing but amount of the substance which has Avogadro number of the particles in it is calling as 1 mole substance. One mole substance means how can you define? Actually, we have to take gram atomic weight of the substance we have to take, or otherwise gram molecular weight of the substance has to be taken. What is the meaning of this one, sir? Atomic weight expressed in grams or molecular weight expressed in grams, then it is calling as one mole substance. For example, I will tell you something. I want one mole of calcium. One mole of calcium means how much weight of calcium has to be taken? Calcium is it atom or molecule? Atom. Atomic weight in grams. Atomic weight in grams means 40 grams. 40 grams of calcium has to be taken. 40 grams of calcium means is containing how many calciums in it? Avogadro number of the calciums in it. Not like that. I want one mole of water. I want one mole of water means molecule. Molecular weight should be expressed in grams. If you are taking 18 grams of water, indirectly containing how many water molecules in it? Avogadro number of the water molecules in it. No, I want one mole of glucose. One mole of glucose means C6H12O6, together 180 grams of glucose containing Avogadro number of the glucose molecules in it. No, I want just one molecule, not mole, one molecule of glucose I want. One molecule of glucose means single molecule. Single molecule means very less. Molecular weight has to be expressed in AMU. 180 only, but we have to express in AMU. So atomic weight or molecular weight means single atom or single molecule should be expressed in AMU, but not like that. One mole molecular weight in grams or atomic weight in grams, then it is containing Avogadro number of the particles in it. Are you understanding? Yes. Now already you know number of moles. How can you find out weight of the substance by gram molecular weight of the substance? This is important. For example, we have 60 grams of calcium we have. It's containing how many moles of calcium? Weight of calcium 60 by atomic weight of the calcium 40. Yes or no? We are getting how many times? So 1.5 times, no? Yes. 1.5 moles. Are you getting? Actually, I will tell you one more thing. For example, 5 moles. 5 moles of calcium containing dash calcium atoms. How can you do this one? 1 mole containing Avogadro number, then 5 moles containing 5 into Avogadro number, then we can write it here. Number of calcium atoms is nothing but Avogadro number into 5. So number of atoms or molecules, number of atoms or number of particles, number of particles in a substance is equals to number of moles into Avogadro number. 1 mole containing Avogadro number, n mole containing n into Avogadro number. Number of moles can be calculated by using weight of the substance by molecular weight of the substance. All of you understood or no? Yes. Here we have to discuss one more thing, is nothing but STP condition. What is the meaning of STP condition? Standard temperature and pressure. Standard temperature means how much? 0 degrees Celsius, or nothing but 273 Kelvin's temperature, or 1 atmospheric pressure. So at standard condition, this is very important statement. 1 mole of any gas, 1 mole of any gas occupies, 1 mole of any gas occupies how much volume? 22.4 liters of volume. This is important. So STP condition, if you take any gas, but 1 mole occupies 22.4 liters. For example, I will tell you some questions. 5 moles of hydrogen gas at STP occupies how much volume? 1 mole occupy 22.4, then 5 moles occupy so much? 5 into 22.4 liters. So 1 mole containing Avogadro number of the hydrogen, then 5 moles containing how much? 5 into Avogadro number of hydrogen molecules. Are you understanding or no? Like that, questions will be there, but this is the basic thing and very important thing for further calculation. later we have to discuss one more related concept is nothing but limiting reagent. I think you know very well, limiting, controlling. So means what? Limiting reagent means is nothing but a reactant or reagent which completely consumed in the reaction and total reaction is controlled by it, called as a limiting reagent, which is completely consumed in the reaction and controls total reaction is calling as a limiting reagent. For understanding I will tell you. And other than limiting reagent is calling as excess reagent. For example, C plus O2 gives rise to CO2. He given problem to you, 6 grams of carbon combining with 32 grams of oxygen. What is the quantity of the product and limiting reagent? First of all, we have to write down the stoichiometric equation, means balanced chemical reaction, already balanced. Okay, later next step you have to think it, 6 grams, 32 grams. Actually, it is nothing but a coefficient, 1 mole of carbon and 1 mole of oxygen. 1 mole of carbon, atomic weight in grams, nothing but 12 grams. 1 mole of oxygen, nothing but 32 grams. Yes, very good. This is the basic amount and gives how many grams? 44 grams. Okay, there is a standard information, but what he given? 6 and 32 grams. Actually, 32 grams requires 12 grams. Then, required 12 grams requirement is there, but then the requirement given is less. Given is less means what happening? Completely consuming the reaction. That's what is calling as a limiting reagent. Automatically oxygen is the excess reagent. Product is controlled by limiting. So that's why 12 grams gives 44 grams. Then 6 grams gives how much? 22 grams of this one. And he may ask the question, how much oxygen will be remaining? 12 grams consumes 32 grams. Then 6 grams consumes how much? Off. Nothing but 16 is consuming, remaining 16 grams of oxygen will be excess. These are the questions. Is it clear? I will tell you one more question. For example, you have nitrogen plus 3H2 gives rise to 2NH3. Okay, 1 mole of nitrogen, 2 14s are 28 grams and 3 2s are 6 grams will be there, gives 34 grams of ammonia. For example, given this is the 28 grams given, but this is given 2 grams, and how much ammonia producing is a good question. Actually, once you see 28 grams requires 6 grams, here also requirement is 6, but given is 2 grams, then the requirement given is less, means limiting reagent. Product is controlled by limiting. Automatically adjacent one is the excess reagent. 6 grams gives 34 grams, then 2 grams gives how much? 2 into 34 by 6. Okay, you will get it. Now my question, how much excess will be remaining here? Actually, 6 grams consumes 24 grams, then 2 grams consumes how much? 2 into 28 by 6, nothing but 3 times is nothing but 9 times, 9.33, like that. So out of 28, 9.33 is consuming, remaining is around 19 or 18 point something will be remaining. Are you understanding? 1/3 will be consuming. All of you understood or no? This is a very important thing for all calculation purpose. All of you clear? Yes. I think no time is there.